Om Namah Shivaya. Bhadram Pashema Akshabhi, up to that we had seen Devaha, O Devata, the Adhisthana Devata, the presiding deity, because of whom all the functions in our body at the levels of different limbs do take place. Karnebhi Bhadram Shunoyama, may we listen by our ears whatever that is, bhadram, mangalakaram, bhajaniyam, Kalyana Vachanam means those words which unfold Atma Sarupa, Brahma Sarupa, Vedanta. May we hear them. May we have lots of opportunities to be exposed to the teaching of Vedanta. Akshabihi Bhadram Pashyema. Again, with our eyes, may we see something that is auspicious. Auspicious, the form of Saguna Brahma, the Parameshwara, the form of saints, guru, etc. May we see now the subsequent portion. Yajatraha. This Yajatraha can be taken with Yajatraha. Akshabhi Bhadram Pashyema also can be taken. Or it can be connected to the subsequent portion of the mantra. What is meant by Yajatraha? Yajatraha can have two meanings. One, literally, Yajatraha means Agnihotri. So one who does the Agnihotra is called Yajatraha. So here, it is like this. So Yajatraha means it can be addressed to the Devata. Who are these? Yajantam Trayate iti Yajatraha. The one who protects those who take to the performance of the Yajna. So that way it can be taken to whom? The very deities, O Yajatraha. Or Yajatraha can be the seekers themselves, for us only. Who are these? So means Vayam. Vayam means we, who take to meditation by exposing to the teaching of Brahma Vidya, like this. Brahma Vidya Shravanena. By Shravana of Brahma Vidya, by exposing to Brahma Vidya. So what do we do? This. Atma Dhyanadi Shilaha Vayam. We have got disposition to take to Atma Dhyana. Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasana. We such people. Or it can be vocative to devatas to protect those who perform the yajnas, yajatraha. So what is the prayer now? Sirayhi angaihi tanubhi tushtuvamsaha yadai devahitam yadayuhu veshema. Deva. Who are these people? Sirayhi angaihi tanubhi tushtuvamsaha. Those we who pray you. You means who? You all the devata ganas. And who are we? Sirayhi angaihi tanubhi. We endure with the tanu, the body, which has got sira anga. Means we who have got healthy and strong body with all the strong links, such people. See, it is a two prayer. Means we should have such body and health, is it not? Like Satyavan Savitri asked the Buddha. You know, Savitri, how clever she was. she didn't ask that you bring my husband to life. She didn't say, may my in-laws, means father-in-law or mother-in-law who are blind, may they see their grandson, because Satyavan was the only son, their grandson enthroned. You know how many boons were there? Look, they had lost their kingdom also. Number one. So Savitri, father-in-law, mother-in-law should get the eyes. Their eyesight should be restored. Satyavan should be, that means he should come back from the death. Not only that, a son has to be born and again he has to be enthroned with God. The enemies who have captured the kingdom should be restored. Four boons. So like this, we who are endowed with strong body, enjoying health and the strength, we should have it, and with that body we should praise you, etc. So that both are included. So therefore, tanubhi, Tanubhi, another meaning we will see afterward. So Tanubhi with a body which has got sthira anga, strong and that means healthy limbs. Tushtuvausaha, we who praise you, we who are praising you. This tushtuvausaha is a very complicated formation. Stu, stauti, staviti, stute, stavite. Second conjugation, ubhayapada. Stu, that is stauti, staviti, stute, stavite. Those who know little grammar, it will make sense. Otherwise, it will not make sense. Okay? So, means to praise. That is for praise. It's perfect third person, perfect tense, third person plural is tushtuvuhu. For which a suffix vas is added to make a perfect participle. Tushtuvuhu plus vas becomes tushtuvas. It's a noun now. And that noun is declined like vidvas, vidvan, vidvansav, vidvansaha, like that. Tushtuvan, tushtuvansav, tushtuvansaha, like that. So that was tushtuvansaha, the we who praise you. And what praise it is? Referring to the Brahma Swarupa. The praise that makes us appreciate what the Brahma Swarupa is. Brahmanu sandhana lakshanam sutim purvanaha vayam. We are taking to such a praise. What type of praise it is? Brahmanu sandhana lakshanam sutim. Stuti, praise, characterized by Brahmanu sandhana lakshanam. Means that which is endowed with the swarupa lakshana of Brahma. Such we, tushtuvasaha. Or again, the Tanubhi here can be other meaning is like this. Tanubhi means, Tanu also means subtle, sukshma. Tanubhi means also another meaning. One Tanu is body, other one is sukshma brahma gocharadhi shrutibhi. The statements of the shruti, which are very subtle in nature, but what they reveal the Brahma Swarupa. That is, Tanubhi can also mean sukshma brahma gocharabhihi shrutibhi. By shrutis, which unfold the sukshma, the most subtle Brahma Swarupa. By such, that is, the mantras, we are praising you. So then what? We who are praising you like that, Devahitam yadayuhu vashema. We, vashema means prapnuyama. May we gain Devahitam yadayuhu. The longevity, the lifespan with the health and strength blessed to us by whom? You all the devas. It means when you bless us with the life, I am sure you are not going to be miserly. You know? So therefore, shatayu, for 100 years, may we live. 100 years is not enough. 100 years you should have health also. Otherwise, you know, once it happened. One lady said to me many years back, Swamiji, today is my birthday. I said, Jeeve Charada Shatam. I blessed her, Jeeve Charada Shatam. I didn't find any expression on her face. Do you know what is the meaning of that? She didn't know. I said, may you live 100 years. Swamiji, 100 years. She got scared. 100 years? 100 years to live and watch vegetable life, no health, etc. No. It should be with the health and the strength. So therefore, may we live for a long chirajivi, chatayu, may we become. Means when you bestowed the longevity, you will not give one 30 years, 40 years, 50 years, you will not give. It will bless us with the chiranjivitva. So 100 years. But it should be what? With the health and the strength of all the limbs.
Vesem Yadayuhu. So with this mantra, one prayer is over. There are two mantras there. So the second prayer is, so that is in a little diluted way, a little easier way as well. That means invoking different deities and seeking their blessing. Swastina Indro Vriddhashravaha. Vriddhashravaha Indraha Naha Swasti. Last word, Dadhatu is there. That Dadhatu has to be brought with everything. Brihaspatir Dadhatu is there, no? That Dadhatu has to be taken. See, Vriddhashravaha Indraha Naha Swasti Dadhatu. This Indra, the Devendra, the king of God, and he has got an epithet. Vriddhashravaha. Vriddhashravaha means Brihat Kirtihi, whose fame is so great. This famous Indra, so what may do? Naha, us. Swasti, Dadhatu. May bestow on us Swasti, Stu, Asti, Swasti. You know, Swasti Vachana is there, no? Swasti Vachana means, that means praying for good of the individual. Here, what is the good for us? Paripurna Brahmananda. The only real good, the final good is what? The Brahma Swarupa, Brahmananda. So therefore, the famous, the Indra, may that famous Indra, Dadhatu, means may he bestow on us the Paripurna Brahmananda, which is our Swarupa, Dadhatu. Naha Vishvavedaha Pushaha Swasti Dadhatu. So to Naha, to us. Vishvavedaha Pusha. Pusha, Pushan means Surya. Pushan is name of Surya. Pushaha, the Surya, the Lord Sun. And what is his description? Vishvavedaha. Vishvam means Sarvam. Sarvam Veti Janati Iti Vishvavedaha. One who knows everything, that Surya, may he bestow on us Swasti Naha Dadhatu. May he bestow on us the Paripurna Brahmananda Swarupa. Why different deities are invoked that way? See, the different deities have the different field of operation. So if they bless us in their field of operation, my body will be fit to take to this pursuit and finally, and of course, they are also Paramajnanis. Their blessing also have got a direct bearing on the fulfilling what we aspire for. So that way, Swasti Naha Vishwa Naha Vishwaveda Pusha Vishwavedaha Pusha Pusha Swasti Dadhatu. Tarkshaha Arishtanemi Tarkshaha Naha Swasti Dadhatu. To us, who is it? Arishtanemi Tarkshaha. Tarksha means Garuda. Tarksha is Garuda. He has got an epithet. What is it? Arishtanemihi. Arishtanemi. Nemi means Gati. One who speed. The one who has got Arishta Nemi. Arishta means Akuntita, unobstructed. One whose speed is unobstructed. You know, who Garuda is whose vehicle? Vishnu's vehicle. So, Arishta Akuntita Nemihi Gatihi Yasya, that Arishta Nemi, or Arishta Nemi also can mean Dukkha Dhamsakaha, one who destroys the sorrow, Arishta Nemi. Otherwise, one who is very fast in his flying. Of course, there also he was very proud of that and he got a lesson. Garuda was thinking, who can fly like me? Krishna, Lord Krishna, In his Rama Avatara, had promised Hanuman that he will give him darshan in the form of Rama in the Dwapara Yuga Avatara. So, in the Krishna Avatara, once Lord Krishna called Garuda, you go and meet Hanuman and call him, tell him that Krishna has called you. Hanuman, the Garuda, of course, he Lord Krishna, Vishnu, so therefore he faithfully went and he saw Hanuman, he said, a very old monkey, and he said, Krishna is calling you. This is Hanuman. He doesn't recognize anyone other than Rama. Even Krishna, he doesn't care. See, that is one of the drawback in the bhakti. See, Hanuman's bhakti can never be questioned, satya bhakti. Still one flaw was there. For him, Bhagavan was only in the Rama form and not even in the Krishna form. It's a flaw. It's Sarvatma. Sarva Bhutantaratma. Anyway, he said, I'm not coming. Now what Garuda can do? So Garuda faithfully came and reported that he is not willing to come. Then Krishna said, you again go and tell him Rama is calling. So he went and told Rama is calling. And then Garuda took pity on him. This poor monkey, so old, can't walk properly. He said, I can offer you a lift. I can offer you a lift. I can take it to Rama, he said. He said, no, I don't want. You tell, I'm coming, he said, and you go, he said. Okay. So Garuda came. I told him, and Hanuman has told, he's coming, he is going to come, he said. Krishna told him, he came and went back. He came and went back. Whose speed was greater? Garuda had that arrogance. No one can beat me in my speed. Hanuman already reached. And Lord Krishna gave, you know the story. Lord Krishna gave the darshan in the form of Rama. Now Rama means who else should be there? Sita. Sita. Now, who will be Sita now? Rukmini or Satyabhama? You know, between these two. Of course, Rukmini had no grudge, but Satyabhama had this grudge and whole Krishna should be with me. So Krishna wanted to teach a lesson to Satyabhama also. Satyabhama, I have to give darshan to Hanuman in the form of Rama. You dress properly like Sita and come. And he with all makeup came. He said, what is this? Look, Hanuman is the one who knows Sita for ages. He will run away if he sees you. Then he called him Rukmini. Rukmini didn't do any makeup, etc. Just the border of the sari she took on the head and came and stood. She was real Sita, because Lakshmi she is. So therefore that way, sir. But all this happened and afterwards, who? Garuda reached. So that arrogance was punctured. Anyway, so that Garuda, Arishna Tarkshaha, Arishtaneni, or Dukkha Dhonsakaha, so, Naha Swasti Dadatu, Mehi Bistu Anata Swasti Da Brahma Swarupa Ananda, Brihaspati naha swasti dadatu. Again, Brihaspati. So Brihaspati, who is Brihaspati? Suracharya, Acharya, Guru of Deva. Shukracharya was Guru of Danavas. So here Asuras. But Suras had the Guru of
Brihaspati. So Brihaspati, you know, Brihaspati is highly knowledgeable.
Even the colloquial is, you know,
वो तो बृहस्पति है, बृहस्पति वेरी हाईली
नॉलेजेबल,
लाइक वाचस्पति, लाइक वाचस्पति, वाचस्पति द टाइटल आल्सो गिवन, नाउडेज एवरीवन, देयर आर मेनी हु लगाओ, दे जॉइन वाचस्पति बृहस्पति एटसेट्रा, बट हाईली नॉलेजेबल, वेद ज्ञानी, एंड पुरोहित गुरु ऑफ द सुरा, सो दैट बृहस्पति आल्सो अदर प्रिसाइडिंग डीटी आल्सो इन द शन्नो मित्र यू हैव सीन. So Brihaspatihi naha to us swasti dadhatu. So swasti dadhatu me bestow on us the Brahma Swarupa Ananda. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Shanti tries to ward off the obstructions at the Adhyatmika, Adhibhautika, Adhidayuka level. Next one, chant together. Om yo brahmanam vidadati purvam mantra is from Shvetashvatarupanishad, 6th chapter, 18th mantra, Shvetashvatarupanishad, 6th chapter, 18th mantra, and Shvetashvatarupanishad is from Shvetashvatara Shakha of Krishna Yajurveda. Shvetashvatara Shakha of Krishna Veda, from that Shvetashvatara Shakha is there. Actually, unfortunately, from this Shvetashvatara Shakha of Krishna Yajurveda, only available thing is Shvetashvatara Upanishad. All other Shakhas, other parts are not available at all. Anyway. Om Yaha Brahmanam Vidadhati Purvam. That Paramatma, Parameshwara, Purvam, at the beginning of the creation, Brahmanam Vidadhati. Vidadhati means create. Whom? Brahmanam Hiranyagarbha. That Parameshwara, that Paramatma, who at the beginning of the creation creates the Prathamajaha Hiranyagarbha, Vidhiranyagarbha, Adhishthana Devata of Samashti Sukshma Sharira, and that is there in each and every one of us. Do you know why? Do we have a Sukshma Sharira? That is presided over by what? The deity Hiranyagarbha. That's why Hiranyagarbha has another name. Sutratma. Sutratma. Sutra means what? Sut. Sut means a thread. Like a thread running in and through a garland of flowers or the bead, this Hiranyagarbha Tattva is running in and through of all the jivas. So in and through all the jivas. So created by who? Parameshwara. That Parameshwara, who in the beginning of the creation first creates the Hiranyagarbha, not only that, Purvam Vidadhati, Yaha, that Paramatma, Parameshwara, Tasmai, unto that Hiranyagarbha, Vedans, Yaha, Vai means famous, it is well known in the Shastra, in the Shruti it is very well known, Tasmai, unto that Hiranyagarbha, Vedans cha Prahinoti, imparts the Vedas. The one who first creates the Hiranyagarbha and imparts the Veda to Hiranyagarbha. So you may say, for Pauranically, Vedas are imparted to whom? Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwara, that Brahma, one of the Trinity. So then what is the relation between the Hiranyagarbha and Brahma?
It is like this, actually. As per Maitrayana Upanishad, first created is Hiranyagarbha. But Hiranyagarbha doesn't have gross body. Gross body is only afterwards. It does. Hiranyagarbha is only Samashti, Suksha Sharira, and Dehi, Abhimani, Devata. For Bhoga experiences, what is required? Gross body is required. That is Virat. And Virat has got three prominent manifestations: Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwara. But at other places it is said, Hiranyagarbha, for the bhoga of the sthula jagat, wields the body of Brahma. Which Brahma? Not Brahman. Brahman is Nirupadika. Brahma, masculine gender. Brahman is neuter gender. Brahma, one of the Trinity. That is Vesu. Otherwise the hierarchy is what? Hiranyagarbha, Virat, then the Trimurtis. So here, Vedansha Prahinoti, unto that Hiranyagarbha who imparts the Parameshwara, who imparts the Vedas, Prahinoti Tasmai, Tamha Devam Atma Buddhi Prakasham, unto that Deva, Deity, I surrender. Afterwards it comes, Saranam Aham Prapadde. Aham Sharanam Prapade. I surrender. But for you to surrender, should you not know where this Hiranyagarbha Deva is there? Have you seen? He says, if you say he is in the heaven, etc., how to go to the heaven? And even if there is some visa is there, this body will not be allowed there at all. So is it not? No, 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 he is so close to you. Without that you can't do anything at all. How? Say that Devam, Atma Buddhi Prakasham. He is not far. Have you got Buddhi or not? Never mind whether Kushagra or otherwise, okay? whether that Buddhi is sharp or dull, never mind. But have you got Buddhi or not? At least are you Buddhu or not? Who is Buddhu? One who has got Buddhi, but that Buddhi is dull. That's all. That's what he calls Buddhu. Anyway, so you have that Buddhi or not? That Buddhi, how do you know? Does it think or not? Whatever it thinks, right or wrong, do you know or not? Atma Buddhi Prakasham. That which illumines, that which makes the buddhi, your antakana, buddhi means antakana, mana buddhi, ankara, chitta, know, makes it know, illumines, that is what atma buddhi prakasham, that permission. Now where is it? Away from you. In your buddhi antakana, each and every blessed thought that comes, whether it is good or bad or indifferent, is made known to you by who? This Deva. Same thing in Keno Upanishad, it is said, Pratibodha Viditam Matam, Bodham Bodham Pratividitam. With respect to each and every thought, the principle, knowledge principle, which makes you aware of that thought, is what? This Deva Tattva Paramatma. Tattva, Parameshwara, Tattva. So Atma, Atma means one's own. Atma Buddhi Prakasham. Me, who is that me? Mumukshuhu. Moktum Ichhu. The one who wants to get freed from this Sukha Dukkha Atmaka Samsara. Where more sorrow is there than the Sukha. We run after the Sukha but we never get it. Do you know why? We are searching at a wrong place. You know, once a gentleman was going somewhere, he was very hungry. So, he went to a canteen. There was a canteen, and that canteen happened to be army canteen, non-vegetarian. Non-vegetarian army canteen. Actually, board was there, but he didn't look at it, he went inside. And this fellow was South Indian Orthodox Brahmin. And he went, the waiter came, "Sir, what can I give you?" He said, "Look, I'm very hungry. First give me idli sambar, and afterwards dosa. Because dosa takes some time, no?" The waiter started blinking. "Sir, did you not see the board there?" "What is it?" "It's a non-vegetarian army canteen. How can you expect idli sambar and dosa?" Likewise, Bhagavan Sri Krishna has kept a board for this world. Anityam asukham lokam imam prapya bhajasvama. So what is this world? Anitya asukha. And what we expect from this world? Like idli sambar and dosa from the non-vegetarian canteen, we expect sukha and nityatva from this. So Bhagavan will say, "I have already told you, anityam asukham lokam imam prapya bhajasvama. You have entered this world. Do you know what it is? It is anitya. It is asukha." He didn't say dukkha, because something appears like sukha, really not sukha. By the time you think that you got sukha, what happens? That sukha goes away and you are running in problem. So therefore, in life when sorrows come, don't get disturbed. It is natural. Why? Life is like that only. Suppose you get happiness, thank your stars, okay? Thank your stars, because, see, there is a world which is anitya sukha, you got little bouts of joys here and there. So therefore he says, so me, who is that? Mumukshu, who has discovered that this world is anitya and asukha, and I want to get rid of that once forever, never to return. So goodbye forever, they say. Satya Sai Baba says, life is like a newspaper. Today's newspaper is tomorrow's waste paper. Like that, in life there will be many prominent things. Yeah. And how do you read newspaper? Few headlines here and there, few things of your interest. There may be some people for paisa vasool the whole day. They have nothing else to do. That is a different thing. But generally, nobody reads all the entire newspaper, and nowadays it is not possible at all. They are earning money at your cost by advertisement. Okay, whatever it may be. So you just important things there and you throw it. Tomorrow's waste paper. Like that, don't give over exaggerated importance to the things in your life. Many ups and downs may be there, don't give much importance. Throw it. How? Never to return. Throw in such a way, once this body is cast off, no return ticket. But we, how you travel? With confirmed return ticket. But not only confirmed return, irrevocable. It can't be revoked at all. So not that way, see. So therefore, don't give over-exaggerated importance to the happenings in life. They come, they go like the passing clouds. Satya Sai Baba has got this habit. Anything is passing clouds. They are like passing clouds. Clouds are not going to be there permanently. Everything is passing. You know that story? Even this will pass away. You know? The old story from Greek or Italy or someone. One youngster could not earn much. Could not earn much. Because there were no job opportunities or even trade opportunities. So he thought of migrating to some other country and sought the permission of the father. Father was reluctant to allow him to go because not nowadays were jet flights and supersonic flights are there. So once gone means almost lost only. But the youngster was very adamant and he convinced the father, look what life I am living here. Okay, beta, my blessings are there for you. And while departing, as a parting gift, he gave him a ring. So and told him, look, in life, whenever you are in distress, remove this ring and go on revolving it and see to the ring very minutely and intently. Of course, the father has given a loving gift as such. He wore the ring and he left. And there he started business. And the business started flourishing. And he, because olden days, the mercantile was transported in the ships. So he purchased a big fleet of ships and started doing the trade from one country to other. And became a very rich person and a man, that means honored in the society. Once it happened, when his fleet of ship was coming with the fully loaded with the mercantile, in a storm, all the ships sank with the mercantile. The news came. Within a moment, he is a pauper now. Fleet of ship gone. At the same time, that much of costly mercantile also gone. He said, there is no point in living anymore as such. So he thought of committing suicide. He went to the outskirts of the city, on a bridge, river is flowing, and he thought of jumping into the river. Suddenly he remembered what his father had said. Father had said, when you are in distress, remove the ring. He was wearing the ring, and revolve it and observe minutely. He said, means anyway I am going to die. Why not obey the command of my father? So he removed the ring and started revolving and looking at it very minutely. You know, inside the ring, the small letter, it was inscribed, even this will pass away. You know that? Even this will pass away. He thought, look, I was a poor youngster. I came here. I earned so much. I became a rich. So that poverty went, I became a rich. Today, again that riches have gone, I become a pauper. Even this will also go. He got solace and returned home. By that time returned home, all the friends and relatives came to know this has happened. He said, why do you fear? We are there to help you. And they came to the rescue and he started his business again. So these are all such things in life are what? They are passing clouds. Even this will pass away. So therefore, so me, who is a mumukshu, wants to get freed from this samsara, which is sukha dukkha atmaka, more sorrow. Sukha cannot be really expected in this samsara. So me, aham sharanam prapadde. Sharanam prapadde. I surrender to you. So this sharanam is a very interesting word. You know, sarva dharmam parityajya mamekam sharanam vraja. Sharanam e, sharanam gam, sharanam ya, means to take the shelter. How this word has come? This word has come from a verb, shru, ninth conjugation, parasmaya pada, shunati. Shru, shunati, means tear asunder. tear to pieces, destroy, kill. This is the verb to which a lyut pratyaya, a suffix is added to make it an abstract noun. Shru plus lyut is a Panini grammar suffix, sir. That becomes sharanam. So what is sharanam? Shunati dukkham anena iti sharanam. That which dispels away the sorrow. That which removes the sorrow. Therefore, a home, a house is called sharanam. Agaram. A house is called sharanam. Do you know why? Your sorrows of heat and cold rain gets dispelled by what? A shelter called home. That is, house or a protector. One who protects you, rakshita, also is called sharanam. Rakshanam, protection also is called as rakshanam. And this word has got sharanam also means kill also is sharanam. Okay, the difference, but here it doesn't occur. A refuge, a place of refuge, shelter, protection. Sharanam means a refuge, a place of refuge, shelter or protection. Sharanam, that is sharanam prapadde. I seek the shelter means I seek shelter in you. How Brahma can give you shelter from samsara? I have to discover myself to be Brahma Swarupa, free from samsara. So therefore, I surrender to you, I take shelter in you. Sharanam aham prapadde. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. As usual, three times the Shanti for dispelling the papatraya. Om Swasti Prajadhyaya Paripalayanta Nyayena Margena Mahimahesha Gobrahmanibhya Shubhamastu Nishtam Loka Samasta Sukhimo Bhavantu Kare Vashyatu Parjanya Prithi Sasya Shani Desho Yamsho Paradita Brahmana Santo Nirbhayah Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhina Sarve Santo Niramaya Sarve Brahmi Pashyantu Nakasya Dukkha Bhaghavi Asato Ma Sadgamaya Tamaso Ma Jyotirgamaya Mrityorma Amritamgamaya Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavasishyate Om Shanti.